constructed a lecture series last year that got people off of campus and into communities, engaging with community partners, with residents, with activists and entrepreneurs and leaders. And I think it was pretty successful. What we wanted to do was continue with some of the topics that we explored last year and actually seek to stay with them for several years to come so that we can look at them from different angles or vantage points so that we can really nurture an actual working partnership with community organizations that are helping us. So this year, we stuck with discussions of racial consciousness that began last year, and we stuck with the issue of exploring community trauma. We folded in two new social justice issues. That would be the issue of fracking and environmental justice more generally. And we took a look at human trafficking this year. So I expect that our attention to those issues will continue going forward.
So on this side, there are 30 bunk beds, 30 beds on this side. This is our shelter, 30 women. It's come as you are, first come, first serve, no preconditions. So when you come here at 4 or 5 in the afternoon and you say, I need a bed, you're not filling out a form to say why. You're not saying I'm a domestic violence victim, I'm this, I just came out of jail. You just show up. If we have a bed and we can determine that there are no health and safety issues, the bed is yours. So this population rotates daily.
In the Pittsburgh area, there have been cases in agriculture and with mushroom farming, and two identified cases of domestic servitude, where a young woman came over under the guise of getting an education or being a nanny, and so these were not U.S. citizens, and was kept in a home and not allowed to leave. One was in Fox Chapel, or in that area in the suburbs, and one was in Squirrel Hill. So these things are happening here.
White privilege means not constantly having your intelligence or integrity questioned just because you are black or a person of color. It means not having to work that much harder just to safeguard yourself from critique when you achieve prominence. Whiteness is invisible to white people. A white person doesn't think of themselves as white. White people are just people. And we have that experience. So when people talk about what is normal or what is average, most of the time, they're not talking about me. They're talking about you.
My perspective is that one cannot possibly talk about fracking without coupling it with energy on the global scale. And so one has to look at the fracking controversy in the United States and couple it with energy issues in Europe and in China and India. And you have to look at the whole big picture, and you can't just focus on what's happening in Western Pennsylvania.
My personal experience over the last 4 years, you know, says that there's a lot of problems out there, and they're not made up and they're not imaginary, that they're real. And until we accept that and face that, we're not going to address it. There is, as one person in the industry or related to the industry said, collateral damage. And, you know, collateral damage, it becomes a social justice issue.
Last year, in this very same room, we all came together, members from the community, some of whom are the same who are here, and we have some of whom who are new additions to the Focus family. We came together and we discussed this issue of community trauma. You know, it really struck me talking with Darlene, talking with Matt, about how we didn't want this just to be a conversation. We wanted this to be a conversation that inspired action. We wanted this to be the beginning of something greater that transformed our community.
I hope that folks will take a look at the work that we're doing and that they will see the lecture series as opportunities to leverage existing resources, to pool our resources so that we can together be better stewards and take more coordinated approaches so that we can provide a more comprehensive look at some of these issues and work together to achieve not only a better understanding of the complexity of these particular social justice issues, but also work together to achieve more effective educational outcomes and more effective social action.